a perfect night here in the capital city of Atlanta, Georgia. We've got the roof open, and we are ready to go at Mercedes-Benz Stadium. A moment ago, here was the scene. The Falcons coming out from their tunnel to the roar of all the folks here in Atlanta. We're ready for football as these Falcons get set to match up with the Carolina Panthers. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. Throwing here on first down. They'll get this out to Kamara. Kamara's got the first down and then some. And he'll take it to the 43-yard line.
I like it. I like it. I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game. And you know you can create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the backfield.
And on the first drive, that can also help establish some rhythm, right?
I think so. And gets everyone involved. They feel like they're part of it and really gets them amped up as they go forward.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Back to throw. Making the catch, this is the tight end, Oliver. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. Well, this crowd does not like that call.
Understandable reaction from them. That's their team that the penalty's going against, but you and I both know they're going to take care of the quarterback.
So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense, first and 10. He'll look to throw. Forced out to his left. And he wisely will throw that one away.
It's nothing but pressure to affect the accuracy and the timing of a guy trying to throw the football. And on that play, they ended up flushing him to his left, contacted him as he's trying to throw the football, and that led to the incompletion.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And they're going to get him. He's sacked back around the 28. Give the sack to Lorenzo Carter.
He seemed to have a reasonable amount of time in the pocket, but he couldn't get rid of the football, and the end result, Charles, him on the ground.
Yeah, he's got to keep an internal clock to go along with his offensive line. When you're talking about 3, 4, 5 seconds, that's a reasonable amount of time to expect to deliver the ball downfield. So great to try and complete a pass. It's equally important to know when to throw the football away, too.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to. Gonzalez's kick is good. Well, all offseason, probably a lot of thought goes into that first drive of week one. They didn't get the touchdown, but at least they got something.
And what I like about it is that they didn't overthink it, because you're exactly right. A lot goes into the offseason, the preseason, to get to that first drive of the regular season. They went right downfield, mission accomplished, points on the board.
And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25.
Play action with Wilson. This to Hines on the drop off. And not much to speak of. Call it a 1 yard gain up to the 26.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage, because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
The last play got just a yard. Here's second and 9 from the 26. Play action. It's Wilson.
This is Chase Claypool on the receiving end.
And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40.
Well,
But I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Play action. Now Wilson. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Counting down toward the midway point in quarter one. From the red zone now, here's Wilson on first down. Flushed out right. And able to get this down inside the 15, either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds. He'll get five out of the scramble. It's second down. Wilson on the keeper, and he will take it in for a Falcon touchdown. Zach Wilson keeping it himself from a yard out, and the Falcons have taken the lead. Extra point by Koo, up and good, and that makes it a 7-3 lead. Touchdown. Here's Koo to kick off. He will return this from deep in the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And Charles, nothing like squaring off with a division opponent, a division rival in week one. Do you like that they are matching up this early, or would you prefer a game like this be a few weeks down the road?
I actually like the early matchup for a few reasons, Brandon. First of all, it allows you to see that the entire offseason and know, hey, right out of the gate, we're playing a division game. Second part is it spreads them out a little bit. If you just have them all bunched up at the end of the year, that's not as much fun watching teams try to survive that gauntlet when you do have injuries down the stretch. And last but not least, let's face it, we're TV people. What a great game to sell right out of the gate.
A good run, got seven on first. Here's second and three. They'll drop the throw. Open right side, complete to Rager. And he goes out of bounds. It looks like right at the 50.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at it, and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out, to the sideline, and make a catch.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Buying time to his left. He's going to look deep for more. And incomplete on the deep ball.
I may be an analyst, but I'm also a fan. I love it when people take the big shots downfield, but he was under a lot of duress, and I think that forced the incompletion downfield. Didn't have a real good chance to find his target.
Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. On play action, they'll throw. This ball complete to Rager. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. After the penalty, a fresh set of downs. It's first and 10. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by A.J. Terrell. And the Falcons are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. After the interception, here's Wilson. He'll check this down to Hines. Not much there, only a yard.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Second and 9 now from the 21. Now Wilson. Open man is Kyle Pitts, his tight end. And he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. Back now in Atlanta, second quarter action. The Falcons with the football as they've got it with a third down coming up. Naeem Hines, his first carry. And he's able to get it to the 31, and that's enough for the first.
That's quite a spot there for his first carry of the game, but obviously they had plenty of faith in him, didn't they?
No question about it. And here, why not go with the fresh legs? Able to push forward, pick up that first. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Wilson. That's into the hands of Pitts, the tight end. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. As long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
And that will be taken in by Ridley for a Falcon touchdown. Now Younghoe Koo for the extra point. And this one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told them, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football, and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
And they're able to get this one across the 35.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon, and it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
Now the pass, and it's into the arms of Hopkins. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Okay, so now the question, how did he get that wide open?
Well, we both know that he shouldn't, because from the time they handed out scouting reports before this game, He was circled, starred, everything. Find him, cover him. But sometimes you can scheme a guy open. You put the receivers in a bunch. Maybe you move some motion. Maybe you put him on the backside of a formation, and all of a sudden you've got a better matchup. Every now and then, the offensive guys, they figure a way to get him open, even with everyone keeping eyes on him.
And that's certainly a guy they want to keep trying to scheme open.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Again, he'll drop to throw. And that'll be incomplete.
You can tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. They'll look to throw again. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Hopkins. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. He's got a man on the crossing route. That's Moore. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago, because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
They go play action here on first down. Strip, the ball comes out.
A lot of bad news on that play for them, wasn't there? Lost the football, lost a lot of yardage, but I think the good news outweighs it. Able to retain possession. That was big for them.
So they keep the ball, but work to do on second and long. They'll set up to throw. This is caught. Touchdown. DeAndre Hopkins, 23 yards for the touchdown. And the Panthers have got it back to a one-score game. Gonzalez good on the extra point, and the lead is down to 4. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. No return here for Clay Brooks, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. 2 drives, 2 touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
And they work this well upfield across the 45. And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. We remind you that coming up at the half, we'll hand things off to Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll have scores from earlier today, plus a look ahead as well, so you won't want to miss that. A lot going on here in week one. Meanwhile, Wilson's throw into the hands of Pitts here. And he'll be down at the 46. So they go from one 46 to the other on a pickup of 8. He was out there waving his arms. And when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion. Yeah, once more, strong running. Excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. They go play action now. Wilson. Throw right side, caught by Ridley. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone.
The goal for any offense versus his own defense, find the holes where guys are available, and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. from the red zone now. They'll look to throw. Open man is Samuel, complete. And the Falcons are going to have a first and goal as the tackle made at the 10-yard line. The Falcons going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one. They scored touchdowns on drives one and two, and now they're trying to make it a perfect 3-for-3 to start. Now Wilson. This is caught. Touchdown, Falcons! Calvin Ridley, as the first half is winding down. And the Falcons would extend their lead here just before halftime. Two able to connect on the extra point, and that makes it a 21-10 game. So the extra point good, and the roughing call going to move the ball out to the 50 for the kickoff.
And I think this is a good chance to pin them deep if you can land the kickoff inside the 5-yard line or so. Gain some field position for your defense.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Clock at 20 seconds to go in the half as they come up first and 10. The play action fake. They'll look. And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
He certainly had a good game throwing the ball so far, but I think he was trying to take that from good to great with that throw, trying to get one downfield.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. He'll get that complete to Albert O. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. They'll throw now on the final play. He's going to throw one up for the end zone. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. Jordan Rager as time expires in the first half. And the Panthers get a late touchdown here on the final play of the first half. Gonzalez now to add the extra point. And he's got it to make this a 21-17 game. So we have reached halftime here in the Thursday night opener as we'll head down to Orlando. That's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. From the end zone comes Chris Claybrooks to return. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the set? Looking there for Pitts, but intercepted. Picked off around the 41. And the return will be stopped at the 34-yard line. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. They'll get this out to Kamara. And they can't bring him down. And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15.
Well, they certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game. And there he picks up another first down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it. And no adjustment has been made to take it away.
Now a first down carry. It's Kamara. And this play goes nowhere, losing yardage back to the 15. So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
But we always talk about how you've got to be quick when you go through your progressions, and here's another prime example. Trying to look downfield, he's standing in the pocket, but just couldn't find anyone open, could he?
No, not enough time. They hit him and forced that incompletion. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. They'll drop the throw. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. DeAndre Hopkins, already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Panthers are going to jump back in front. Gonzalez able to tack on the PAT, and that gives him a three-point lead. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. Clay Brooks going to bring this one out. And not a good return here at all, as they'll be forced to start at the 12-yard line. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one play.
The ball comes out, and this will get out of bounds right at the line of scrimmage. So fortunately, they're able to hold on to the possession.
I don't know about you, but I can hear and feel the sigh of relief all the way up here in our booth.
That was palpable. The sideline, the friend there.
No doubt about it. Ball goes over the sideline, able to retain possession, no turnover. I know his coaches are screaming, just hang on to the ball, man.
There's a ball thrown right side and complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets this football out shy of the 30 to the 29. Play action. Now Wilson. Over the middle, that's caught by Claypool. And he's brought down after a very nice gain.
I'll tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available, because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them. And these guys have been taking advantage so far.
From midfield now, here's Wilson. This to Hines on the drop-off. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40.
I love the drive they're working on here, because they know they can take the lead with a touchdown. And so far on this drive, so good. They've moved the ball down the field with very little resistance defensively. But they better be prepared for some adjustments to come their way now.
He's going to air one out. And that is caught. Touchdown, Falcons. Naeem Hines, 36 yards. And the Falcons have once again taken the lead. Extra point by Koo, up and good. And that will make this a four-point game. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. And no return on this one, as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And the points, they have come fast and furious in this quarter.
You really don't want to be on the defensive side of the ball right now, do you? Because you're either thinking, my replacement may get an opportunity.
Your head better be on a swivel.
Totally. Or maybe I just need to get out of the game for a while, because I just can't slow these guys down. They've got to figure out a way to disrupt these offenses. And typically, one guy makes a big play, and that can help change things.
They'll be looking for disruption on both sides right now. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35.
That was a fun one to watch right there. A nice in-breaking route and plenty of room in the middle of the field. And he was able to get behind the linebackers and grab the completion for a really good pickup.
And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down. To throw. That'll be caught. It's Rager. And he'll have it past midfield, almost to the 40, before being taken down. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
From the gun, it's a run for Kamara. And he's going to get this inside the 30.
Most of their damage has been done through the air. I mean, they've rung the bell three times with passing touchdowns, but guess what? Ground game has not been neglected. Nice little burst right there.
Now a play fake here on first down. And he slings one that's incomplete.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbounds because they are very gifted. They'll make the circus catches, but if they make them out of bounds, that does you no good.
Second and 10, third quarter of the season opener. Now back to throw. DeAndre Hopkins making the catch. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. He's been a busy man here in this one, and they're showing off some nice footwork to stay in bounds.
And with those types of catches and the volume that we've seen in this game, wouldn't you keep him busy as well?
I would.
Of course. You got to keep throwing it to him. He keeps making plays.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
Well, he certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
On second down, Kamara. And he'll be taken down here at about the 11. Out of the huddle now for play number 9 on this drive. This is third down and 8. They'll look to throw here. And probably the wise decision there. No one open. He just throws it away. And that keeps the field goal on the table as it's fourth down. Gonzalez's kick is good, and that'll bring him back within a point. So give him 3 on that drive. You know, normally you'd say, we'll take it, but the way points have been flying around, it feels like a little bit of a letdown.
Yeah, you just have to wonder, are field goals going to be enough? Because as you pointed out, the way touchdowns have been scored, does kicking a field goal actually put you at a disadvantage the rest of the way?
And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. Doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
A big play there on the catch and run. The big play has them all the way out near midfield for a first and 10. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. Eluding the pressure right. They'll find Hines out of the backfield.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
Now Wilson on first down. Escaping the pressure right. Space to run past the 20. And this turns into a nice gain with a slide at the end. One quarter remains here in this Thursday night matchup. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. This to Pitts, and he's got him. Touchdown, Atlanta. Kyle Pitts there to make the grab. And the Falcons will add on to their lead. Koo able to connect on the extra point. And that will ensure that it will take a touchdown and a two-point conversion to tie it. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. This taken in at the goal line. Oh, a dangerous return man showing it here. He's at the 40. Past the 20.
Prime time, baby.
And he'll bring it back all the way. Touchdown, Carolina. So that will push him back.
And now we know why he had a little extra space to run, don't we? An illegal block in the back. That penalty will move them back.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Dancing to his left. He's going to look deep for more. And got his man complete. A big connection on that one. 38 yards. So after the big play, look at this. All the way down at the 15 now on first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. DeAndre Hopkins with now 3 week 1 touchdowns. And the Panthers have a chance to tie things up as they trail by 2 here in the fourth. And now remember, all touchdowns are reviewed. And in a tight game like this, they're going to take a good long look at it. So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. Gonzalez good on the extra point, and now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And they've seen their lead nearly extinguished after that last score. But bottom line, they are still on top with the football. And a touchdown on this drive would really put them in position A. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Wilson's throw into the hands of Pitts here.
Well, that should be a reminder defensively, and I think it's a reminder to myself because you just can't sell out to stop the run. There's still enough time that this offense can move the football through the air, even on first and second downs, and they obviously picked the right spot to throw the ball there.
Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end, and he'll go out of bounds. It appears right at the 45. 7 yards, the pickup there. Looking to throw again on second down. Wilson, flush to his right. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Now he steps away. And he'll just get rid of it.
I know you're thinking it, but I'll just go ahead and say it. To give you an idea of how sharp he's been in this game, just his second incompletion, and we're in the fourth quarter.
He has been locked in, laser-focused all throughout this one, hasn't he?
Certainly has, and he's gotten some help from his receivers as well. They also are locked in.
Yeah, the drops have been at a bare minimum. To throw again on second down. Wilson, throw right side, is going to be caught by Samuel. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers 33.
When the hitch route is run really well, that jab step off the line of scrimmage by the receiver, which is designed to back up the defender and give him a little bit of space, all you want there, get that space, catch the football, and then make a move and pick up extra yardage, and that's exactly what he got done there.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Off the play fake, here's Wilson. Throw right side, caught by Ridley. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down, stomp down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. To throw again is Wilson. He'll check this down to Hines. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space. It turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
And the Falcons are going to have it first and goal as he'll take this down to about the 3. How about
this offensive line. They're really starting to establish themselves, take over this game.
And before the series began, I know exactly what was said in the defensive huddle. Guys, we got to get no less than a three and out. Let's get off the field. Instead, they can't find any traction towards doing that. Right now, they're just getting muscled all over the field and getting pushed down it.
So it's Falcon football as we welcome you back. They've got it first and goal as they search for what could be a game-sealing touchdown. They'll try to run with Hines. And after the good game last play, this time they say, uh-uh, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage. And now we'll see a timeout used on defense as they stop it right out of the break with 1:57 to go in the ballgame. On second down, it's Hines. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. And whistles, and we're going to have another stoppage of play as they call the timeout on defense with 1:53 left. A big play, if you think about it, right now in this season opener. It's third and goal. They'll try to run this one in, and he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Naeem Hines. Second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Falcons will extend their lead. They do take on the extra point as well. And that will ensure that it will take a touchdown and a two-point conversion to tie it. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he returns this to the 22. Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offensive sails, because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager.
And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. After the sack here, second and 11. He'll look to throw. Gets this to Moore. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds.
Well, they got the yardage they needed there. Picked up the first down. Got out of bounds. How about the urgency that they have, as well as the understanding where they are on the field?
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Back to throw. Out to his left. And a catch made by Hopkins. They'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Working the sideline there. Good route, good catch. First down, and he gets out of bounds.
Now you have to like the play call, because you have to run some guys down the middle of the field to draw some of the defenders away. They can't just let them guard the sideline exclusively. That's how it's going to work. Sidelines and incompletions to use the clock.
They'll look to throw. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. No, he didn't spike it. He faked it. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down.
Well, collectively as a defense, Charles, I think if you get 4 sacks a game, you're feeling really good. Now they have 6 as a unit.
And that type of a number is just staggering, because there's so many ways to try and counteract it. But in this case, they've got no answers for this unrelenting pressure coming at their quarterback.
A big pickup, 18 yards, but they still stop him well short of the marker. One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Try it here. He's back to throw. Steps away to his left. He's going to look deep for Moore. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And defensively, that might just seal a week one victory. They go down to a knee, and the new campaign off to a good start. It's a win here in week one.
I do get a kick out of seeing a team kneel down at the end of the game in victory formation and wrap one up, because most of the time a kneel down is not a good thing in football. In this case, it's the best thing for the team that's winning.
Best thing week one, and 1-0 after going down to that knee.